Clinton campaign volunteer Christy Slavik Hamilton, on a frigid Friday night in Manchester, New Hampshire, continues checking houses off her list.
Some people are getting weary of seeing us. So let's see if we can find a way in here. This is Slick.
She remembers being to this one before. Here lives a family that's originally from Ukraine.
You're Tatiana?
Yes.
Since her last visit, volunteers from other campaigns have also come by.
A second say on Jeb Bush, all over.
I know.
I say.
She says she and her son are voting for Hillary.
You're not going to change your mind. I know you're not.
Good. I know.
It's just so important that we elect her. So that is strong for Hillary. So I recorded verbal commit because she verbally told me that.
Christy, a retired English teacher, was introduced to me by the Clinton campaign as an example of the type of dedicated volunteer at the heart of its sophisticated canvassing efforts.
I retired from teaching, but I didn't retire from who I am. Who I am is find your voice, use it, and never, never quit.
She's been doing this work pretty much full time since last summer. Christy provides insight into not just how the Clinton campaign's ground game works.
You're her best ambassadors at the door today.
She also articulates why she thinks, despite polls showing Senator Bernie Sanders is way ahead, Mrs. Clinton will win the primary. Why does she think Hillary can win? Christy's impressed by the resources and know-how that's been invested in the campaign's voter outreach system.
Bedford.
In the final days before the election, she's often responsible for relaying to headquarters who's canvassing.
All right, so these are still a lot of people out.
Where they're from and what materials they've been sent out with, so headquarters can decide how to deploy them next. The Sanders campaign didn't respond to a request for comment on how its outreach efforts here compare. But I visited Arnie Arneson, a local liberal radio personality who was once the Democratic nominee for New Hampshire governor, to get her take.
Do you have any knowledge on whether the Sanders campaign has that same level of sophistication?
It couldn't be. The Hillary campaign is unbelievable. They're trained, they're organized, they say, how many hours can you give us? Two, this is what you do. Six, this is what you do. Bernie, however, is not quite like that.
She doesn't endorse candidates, but she says she's friends with Mr. Sanders, who held an event at her home last year before he announced his candidacy.
He's had some pain organizers on the ground, I'm sure, here, but it's a little more loosey-goosey. And that's not surprising. First of all the operatives are working for her.
A first-class outreach operation is one thing, but convincing voters is another. Here, too, Christy thinks the large pool of still undecided voters here will, on primary day, be more persuaded by Mrs. Clinton's message. Which message is that?
I'm not making promises that I cannot keep.
In other words, Mr. Sanders' promises, like single-payer health care, may appeal to the hearts of many Democrats, but she urges voters to
bring both their heart and their head to vote on Tuesday.
To Christy, that means Mrs. Clinton knows how to work within the system to accomplish her goals.
Your head has to be hand in hand with your heart to really make it work.
Mrs. Clinton has the overwhelming support of voters who say the top quality they want in a nominee is that he or she can win in November, and that he or she has the right experience. Mr. Sanders, by a huge margin, is the preferred candidate among voters who say the top quality they want in a nominee is that he or she cares about people like you and is honest and trustworthy. A Wall Street Journal NBC News Marist poll released Thursday shows Mr. Sanders with a 20-point lead in New Hampshire, and that he has the support of more than three-quarters of voters here who are under age 30.
I don't believe that Bernie can win nationally.
Mrs. Clinton's pragmatism appears to be a big selling point among older voters.
It's what socialists do.
Like 62-year-old Chuck Duggan.
It's like Hillary says, she's not going to make a promise that she can't deliver.
Arnie's not willing to concede that point.
She's saying that he is naive. Let me tell you, he ain't. All right.
Can you understand why a lot of young people out there are inspired by Bernie Sanders?
I have a son who's 28, and he still, I think, is leaning Sanders. At this point in my life, I've come to understand that she's a possible dreamer. She will dream about something and know how to make it possible.
Mrs. Clinton's counting on the efforts of people like Christy to make her dream of becoming president possible. That's the short answer.